Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, I adore you, and I worship you for who you are and what you mean in my life. As I share your word, use me as a vessel to be a blessing to your people. And as you bless them, my Father, do not pass me by. How I pray that I may decrease as you increase, Lord. And this word, let this word come forth with anointing to be a blessing to my listeners and my viewers. And I come against every spirit that comes to distract your people, my Father. Lord, give us a breakthrough in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Welcome to One Word TV. I'm your presenter, Pastor Florence Maina, of the program Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. I'm broadcasting live all the way from Minnesota, USA, and this is a production of One Word Digital Media, which is situated in Seattle, Washington, and we are miles away. But you know what? God is a good God. He gave men ideas, and they put those ideas into action. And those actions combined with all this, I can reach you, you can reach me, my brother and my sister, through this technology. That is why we need to thank God for everything and seize the moment and take advantage of what God has put at your disposal to be a blessing to the body of Christ. The title of my message today will be, get up from your failing point. As human beings, we are bound to fail at some point. We are bound to make mistake because we are not angels. And God understands that. But the worst thing would be you staying in your failing point. A good point, a good example, you can imagine if you are driving and then your car get off track. Are you going to stay there and get stuck there and try to drive and you are stuck? You're going to jump yourself out and try to do something. Man and woman of God, when there is an issue in your life, do not stay in that failure. I'm also going to give another example here. The trash can. Trash cans are very important in our, or dustbins are very important in our houses or in our offices because they prevent dirt and stinking smell in our environment. What you do not use, you put in the trash. But you can imagine if you let that trash stay there for months and months and months, it's gonna smell. It will rot, and out of it will come even the, these animals that are bad. You know, I don't know what to call them, igunyo and all those kind of things. And the house or your environment will be smelly. What am I trying to say, man and woman of God? There are things that comes into our life, but we do not flush them out with the word of God. Because this word tells us in the book of John that the word of God cleanses us. It is like the spiritual water that comes and cleanses up. Flush yourself of those dirt that the enemy has put in your life with praise, with worship, with serving the Lord. My first of reference will be, I'm feeling so much charged, I can preach and preach. I have to be mindful of the time here. Proverbs 24, verse 16 says, for a righteous man may fall seven times and rise again, but the wicked shall fall by calamity. I'll also jump to Luke 15, that which is one of my favorite stories to give examples from. 15:17-19. This is about the prodigal son, but I'm just going to read that part. It says, but when he came to himself, he said, how many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare? And I perish with hunger. I will rise and go to my father and said to him, Father, I have sinned and against heaven and before you, and I am no longer worthy to be called your servant. Make me like one of your hired servants. My brother and my sister, when there is a failing issue in your life, it is not time to stay there. Otherwise, you're going to be like garbage that the enemy will heap and heap. You'll start with guilt, like we are covering in my church about the cup. You start with hurt, with guilt, with fear, with condemnation, with all this and anger, with all these kind of things. Get up. Rise, arise like the prodigal son. Know that a righteous man may fall seven times, yet he shall rise up again. It is your time now to realize where you have been. It does not matter how deep you have been, but you have come to a personal realization of saying, wow, I am not in a good position. I need to do something. This guy, he had asked all that he wanted. You might have gone away from the ways of the Lord. But I want to tell you, when you are there, you have to realize, you have to arise, you have to come back to yourself. My mother tongue says it very well. We shokera. You have to come back to that point and realize, wow, where am I? I am lost. Or like when you are following a GPS and then it tells you take this exit and you ignore it and you continue and you continue. You're going to run out of gas. You're going to get lost. Oh, calibrate your life. That's what the GPS tells you. Take the next exit. Take the next exit of repentance. The Bible tells us in the book of 1 John. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us. But if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us, and we make him a liar. May you come back to yourself. May you arise from that point or you have failed. Don't stick there. I don't know what to do because I'm having so many examples coming. Children, when they start to crawl, when they start to stand up, or they stand up with holding the table, they fall down, they are hit on their rib, but they still stand up. My brother and my sister, stand up, because I'm going to read that verse again in Proverbs 24:16. For a righteous man may fall 7 times and rise again, but the wicked shall fall by calamity. Do not be like the wicked to fall by calamity. I'm not advocating for sins, no. But God does not judge us. There is no condemnation in them that trust in the Lord. Maybe you trusted the Lord. Maybe you used to serve the Lord. Come back. There is still more to be done. A righteous man may fall 7 times, yet he shall rise up again. It is your time to rise up. And even as the heading is, get up from your failing point. You are not meant to be there. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come against the spirit of condemnation that has attacked so many in the kingdom, in our families, in our marriages, in our careers, that when one fail one time, they feel they are going to leave that and go to another major. Father, I pray that there shall be a rising this day for that young man, for that young woman, for that couple, my Father, for that supervisor who was just let go and they are wondering whether there is hope. God Almighty, there is a rising up from our failing point. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you. And I want to tell you, you can continue to listen to this message and other messages by different servants of God from all over by dialing 605-781-3266. Let me repeat that number. 605-781-3266. You can also download the app One Word Digital Media and you'll be blessed 24/7, 366 days a year, free of charge. When you are blessed, be a blessing to another person by sharing. I would also encourage you to subscribe to our channel. If you have not done so, celebrate your moment with joy. If you have done so, God bless you. Continue praying for us. Also, like our Facebook page. I also want to remind you, next Saturday, 7 days from now, Celebrate Your Moment with Joy is hosting a meeting and the theme is persistence that leaves a mark. We need to encourage one another. That's all Celebrate Your Moment is about. And this is a home for spiritual guidance, your voice of hope. I love you and God loves you the most. But I don't want to leave you. You are there. You have never trusted the Lord. You've been put down by reasons, by giving yourself time. Today is the day. Now is the time of your salvation. If you're in that category, do you want to say this prayer after me? Lord Jesus, I'm arising from my sinful position. I'm arising from my giving reasons for many years. And I come before you. I release my life to you. Write my name in the book of life. Forgive me, Lord, and give me a desire to grow spiritually. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. If you have prayed that prayer, that is the best decision you have done for yourself. Now, next step, look for a church nearby where you live that you can be able to be taught the word of God and be equipped and be encouraged. You can't make it alone. If you think you can make it alone because of your money, you are wrong. You need each other. We need each other. I need you. You need me. Go to that church. Introduce yourself. Have at least 3 people you can connect with and you'll expand the fellowship of other brethren in Jesus' name. God bless you.